Hey guys, last week we talked about the five kinds of prohibited speech. So this week what I'd like to talk about is, okay, so what happens if somebody starts speaking in a way that you shouldn't be hearing? Just as much as there's a concept of watching what we say, there's a concept of watching what we hear. So what do we do when we're in a situation where we're listening to something we're not supposed to be listening to? By the end of this video, I'm going to give you four tips what to do in that situation. But first, let's talk about why this is a problem. This is simply a problem because according to halacha, two things happen when you hear negative information you shouldn't be hearing. One is it changes, even in the slightest way, the esteem you had for the person being spoken about beforehand. Even if you don't really believe what they're saying, even if you really don't even think that they're saying anything that's that bad, it can change the way that you see the person being spoken about. And the second thing halacha says is that simply hearing negative information puts us into a negative headspace. Instead of looking at the positives in the people around us and in our lives, it puts us into a negative headspace. So clearly, this isn't something we want to be doing. And it's a very easy thing to get into. Somebody starts making some comments, which maybe you shouldn't be listening to, and according to halacha, you're considered to be actively encouraging them simply by staying around, by possibly asking a question which would cause them to continue talking, to making any gestures which makes it seem like you're interested, or adding your own comments. So, what do I do? Somebody all of a sudden, I don't know, really dislikes this girl Tiffany and decides to start smacking on Tiffany while I'm around. What do I do? Okay, there's four options. And it's really easy to remember because it's an acronym. D-E-A-F. DEF. Okay. Option number one is defend. You can defend the person being spoken about. You can say, oh, really? I don't think she's so bad. I actually think she's really cute and amazing. Problem with this is sometimes when you come in to defend someone, the immediate reaction of the person who was speaking before is to dig in and go deep. So you've got to be really careful how you'd use a defense. Option number two is educate. Letting someone know what they're saying isn't okay. Once again, you've got to be really, really careful. Torah is very not into embarrassing someone publicly. So if you are like in the middle of a conversation and your friend starts saying something that they shouldn't, and you're like, I think that's not allowed, and you make them feel embarrassed, that's also a little bit problematic. If it's a more of a one-on-one situation, it might be easier to use your educate option. Three is my favorite. So defend, educate, A stands for alter the conversation. I love this. I love changing the subject. And considering most of us are like a little attention freestyle these days, you can alter a conversation without anybody really noticing what you're doing. All you have to do is look at the person's talking, find something you think that's cute that they're wearing, and be like, oh my gosh, I'm obsessed with your earrings. Where did you get them? And everyone will just automatically squirrel and change the complete subject. Okay, changing the subject is often the best way to get out of a listening situation without really embarrassing anyone or without making somebody dig in deeper. You simply just sort of make everybody go into a topic that has no problems in it. And option number four is flee. So defend, educate, alter, or flee. That means just run away. Now you can actually physically run away, be like, oop, bathroom, or you can put in earphones or be like, oh, I'm sorry, I'm getting a text, WhatsApp, Snapchat, must go check this. Simply running away from the conversation. Okay, remember, when we hear things that are negative, it puts us into a negative headspace. It might change how we see people, and we could accidentally, simply by being present, encourage the person to just keep talking and digging themselves a deeper hole with the negative speech. So when we hear negative speech, DEAF. Defend, educate, alter, or flee. Have a great day.